A very good morning, class 11th. Today's agenda is to do a titration, and my student Suhani, hi Suhani, would be performing the titration for class 11th. This is an acid-based titration of NaOH versus oxalic acid. The apparatus required for the titration are a titration pump, which helps you to measure exact 10 ml without sucking through the pipette. Under these times of corona, you do require this desperately. You also have a pipette, which is a thin glass tube of 10 ml. So handle it with care. It's glass, I said. A small beaker, I've taken oxalic acid, glass beaker. In the plastic beaker, you have NaOH, the base required. You have a funnel, and you have this bottle of indicator phenolphthalein required for your acid-based titration, because the base used is NaOH. It's a strong base. For all strong bases like NaOH, the indicator used is phenolphthalein. You require a wash bottle, and this is your titration flask. This is like your conical flask. Actually, it is a conical flask. We call it titration flask because we perform our titration in it. Lastly, but not the least, the most important apparatus is this long tube of glass, which I have clamped it onto the stand. And this is the most costly apparatus in the lab, and you will be handling it individually. So please be careful. This long tube has gradations in it. You can see there are values in it. Move up. Fine. So it is lowering down, and it will go up to zero on top. Fine. So from zero, you come to all values. This is around 20. Then you move to around 30, 35, 38, 39, and the last value, as you can see, is 50. Now we will have a closer look as to the divisions between the two digits. Our focus now is on to the readings between the two digits. Let us focus on 49 and 50. Can you see there are 10 lines between 49 and 50? Which means you can measure 49.1, 49.2, 49.3, 49.4, 49.5 will be this long line in between, and then 49.6, 7, 8, 9, and then 50. Which means between two lines you have 10 divisions, which means you have a least count of 0.1 ml. That is the important instruction for the burette. So you can measure volumes up to one decimal place when you are measuring through this burette. The first step required is that you need to clean the burette with water. This is the wash bottle. You need to add water through the top. See that the nozzle is closed. It should not fall off. It is closed. She has locked it up. So she will just add some amount of water to it. Can you see the amount of water in it? She's adding more water. It's rising up. That's enough. Swani, please put the knob on so that we can see exactly what happens when you switch to put the knob off. You can put it into the conical flask. No, I cannot see the knob. Yeah. So you can see this is the knob which helps you to monitor the amount of base that you will be adding into the conical flask. Put it off. This is the knob. So wash it with the water. She just throw it off into the sink. Once this is washed, you need to add the base in it, the one base that you are wanting to use. Add some amount of this NaOH into the burette for rinsing. Now she'll add some amount of base for rinsing. That is the plastic beaker she's using, and that's the base she's adding. So she's added some amount. As you can see, she'll just roll and throw it into the sink so that your burette gets rinsed by the NaOH. Some amount should also be passed through the nozzle so that the nozzle is also cleaned through the NaOH. Now you can fill up the burette with NaOH. You should use a funnel to transfer NaOH into the burette. Add a little more. Can you see the well level rising? That's it. Pass some amount of NaOH through the nozzle so that the nozzle is also full of NaOH before you begin the titration. Fine. Now you are ready with the burette. The second apparatus is this titration flask. This needs to only be washed with water. Add some water to it, swirl it, and then discard it into the sink. Before we begin with the pipette, you need to understand what is this titration pump. This is your suction pump for titration. It has this entry point where you will insert the pipette. It has two connections here. The top is a roller which helps you to pull the liquid up into the pipette, and there is a bar given here. On pressing this bar, the whole liquid gets transferred. So these are the two things that you should understand. She will now be using it for the titration, that is for the pipette. Now to clean the pipette, you need some water in a beaker. And now you can take your pipette. Have a close look. This pipette is to be inserted into the pump. This pipette is a 10 ml device which you require. And there is a cut mark. Have a look at the cut mark. Yeah, there it is. This cut mark is required to know that this is the level till which it has to be filled. Now she'll fit the peptide, the pump onto the pipette. Have a look at the pump. This is the point. Please hold it from the top and then insert it into this entry point. Once done, now you can start filling the water into it. By the roller from top, you can roll it up. The rolling down, please be careful. Now the suction pump is moving up. As you can see, the liquid is also moving up. Can you see the liquid? It should be dipped into the liquid. Otherwise, you will get bubbles. So she is rolling the upper one and your liquid is rising up. Fine. Now she'll discard this water and wash it up into the sink. For discarding it into the sink, you have to press this top white button. And the whole liquid gets decanted off, as you can see, in one go. Just the top button and it gets decanted off. Fine? Now, you need to rinse your pipette with the oxalic acid. Oxalic acid was in the glass beaker. So she will take some amount of oxalic acid via this pump. Taken it up and then you can discard it. This 10 ml will be discarded by this pressing the push button and you will get the total oxalic acid discarded. And your burette is now rinsed with oxalic acid. Now your pipette is ready to be used. You will now measure 10 ml of oxalic acid for your titration through the pipette via this pump. The suction pump will help you take 10 ml of oxalic acid into the pipette. You can see the level of oxalic acid is rising up to this. Take it above the mark and then you can adjust it through this knob. Adjust it to this cut mark. She's adjusted it to the cut mark and now she will introduce this into the conical flask. By pressing the push button, you can transfer the total oxalic acid, which is 10 ml, into the conical flask. So after transferring, tap it twice onto the surface of the titration flask to remove whatever is left. If you are still left with some amount of it in the pipette, have a look at the pipette. This volume is not to be blown off. This is an adjusted volume. Please ignore this volume. This you will not use for your titration. And you can now take your titration flask, add one or two drops of phenolphthalein to it. Just a drop or two. Just a drop and it is colorless, which means phenolphthalein does not show color in acidic medium. So your oxalic acid with two drops of phenolphthalein is ready for titration. Now to take the reading of the NaOH in the burette, let's have a close look. Please see, the reading is in between 13 and 14 and your lower meniscus of this liquid is touching the line of 13.5, or in fact it's 13.4 to be precise. The longer arm se thoda sa zyada hai yahan pe. So it is 13.4 is the reading. Please take the lower meniscus to start the titration. So we begin with the titration taking the volume of NaOH as 13.4. You will take your titration flask below the burette and you will start addition of NaOH to it. She's adding NaOH and you can see a pink color transformed at the center. When she'll stir it, this will vanish. Why do we get the pink color at the center? Because this NaOH which is being added goes to the center and at that area becomes basic. Add a few drops. Which means now the center is basic, that is why the phenolphthalein is showing the color. Now once she stirs it, then it totally becomes again in the acidic medium. She has to continue adding till you get the lightest possible pink. So add cautiously. Please do not add large excess to give a bright pink. Continue adding till you get a lightest possible pink with continuous stirring. She's trying to get a lightest possible pink. Add a few drops more. Check for the pink on this white tile only. Otherwise, you won't know the lightest possible pink. Stir it there itself. That's the lightest possible pink that she's got. So you will observe it onto the white tile, and this is where you will stop. Now we will have to check the reading. Fine, to check the reading, let us go to the level of the NaOH into your burette. Can you see it? Yeah, it is in between 23 and 24. Please check the lower meniscus. The lower meniscus is touching the second line below 23. So the reading is 23.2. The final reading where you got the lightest possible pink is 23.2. Fine? It will not be called 23. You will not check with the upper meniscus. The lower bend of the line, that is to be checked, and that is 23.2. So if you are asked how much was the NaOH used to get this lightest possible pink color, your answer would be your final reading was how much? 23.2. And the initial reading was 13.4. So 23.2 minus 13.4 will give you the value of NaOH used, and your answer is 9.8. Now this titration is to be done at least 3 times till the volume of NaOH becomes constant. In chemistry, you do not take the average out. You will have to do it the titration 2 to 3 times till your value of NaOH used in the titration falls again onto a same reading, let's say 9.8 in this case. And that will be the reading used for all calculations. You can refer to the other videos for calculations for your titration of NaOH versus oxalic acid. With this, we come to the end of the titration. We have learnt or redone the procedure for titrating oxalic acid versus NaOH using phenolphthalein and the titration pump handling. Fine. With this, we come to the close. Thank you, Suhani. Bless you loads, each one of you. Stay safe, stay healthy, work cautiously, and do well in life. Do awesomely well in boards. Bye.